LinkedIn is the ultimate social network for finding professional opportunities or promoting yourself. Hi, Karen here, and today I'm showing you how to create a LinkedIn account. If you're not familiar with this social network, I've included a video in the description that explains in detail why it's useful and how it works. Now that we've covered that, how do you create a profile on it? It's simple. Enter your email address, create a password, then enter your first and last name. LinkedIn may ask for your phone number to confirm that you're a real person. You'll quickly see that there are a lot of fake accounts on LinkedIn, but that's another story. So once you've entered this information, all you have to do is specify where you live and finally what you do for a living. If you're a student, just enter what you're studying instead of your job. Here I'm going to create a student profile. So I will enter the name of my institution, the type of diploma, what I'm studying, and the years of study. LinkedIn sometimes changes the order of the steps when you create an account, but you will generally find the same steps, including email confirmation. As you can see, you can immediately specify whether you're looking for a job. Even if you are, I recommend specifying it after optimizing your profile to make it more attractive to recruiters. To continue, you can also add people you may know. I will do that later in the video because I prefer to have a profile photo first. But you can do it now if you want. It's up to you. Now, let's talk about profile pictures. Your photo should be professional. So if I had to give you some advice, it will be use a recent photo of yourself. Make sure it's high quality, even if you have to pay for a photographer. Be alone in the photo. Show at least half of your upper body. Add color and or dynamism. And keep the background plain or make sure it looks professional. Of course, if you don't like your face, you can also create an avatar. You can do this with Apple's Memojis or even with Bitmojis directly from Canva. You can customize your photo with Canva or with PFP Maker, which is a software created specifically for this purpose. You import a photo of yourself into the tool, choose a background color and background of your choice, and you can even customize the final look of your profile photo in more detail. Once you're satisfied, simply download the photo and add it to LinkedIn. Finally, it's up to you to choose the interests you want to follow. You'll be able to find their news in your feed and stay up to date on topics that interest you. As LinkedIn points out, it's best to follow at least 5 to find content that interests you. There's nothing here that interests me, so I'd rather not select anything. Now that my profile is created, I need to complete it. This is part of optimization. A complete profile looks more professional. Plus, you can highlight what you want people to see at first glance. To save time, you can import your resume so that AI can detect your past experiences. Personally, I'm going to do it manually. So if you are a student, you can add your experience if you have any. It's okay if you don't have any, we all started with a blank resume. In that case, you will need to fill out the rest of your profile even more to show your motivation. Here, I'm going to add a summer job. Whether it's your studies or your work, remember to provide details about what you do, just as you would when filling out a resume or cover letter. As you can see, you can add skills. Don't skimp on that. All skills are good, especially if you are a student. When someone searches on LinkedIn, skills are taken into account. So for instance, if you're knowledgeable about organization or English, be sure to list them in your skills, because if someone searches for the keyword organization, your profile may appear. In addition, you can specify in which experience or studies you were able to strengthen this skill, which is an asset for recruiters. On LinkedIn, you can add a profile picture to introduce yourself visually, a banner that I'll show you later, and a headline to describe what you do. These elements are important because they're the first thing visitors to your profile will see, so I recommend really thinking about what you want to highlight. For instance, you can make your headline more fun and stand out from the crowd. Next, you need to add a LinkedIn banner. The banner allows you to quickly summarize what visitors to your profile need to know about you in 5 seconds. When you create it, you need to think about what your potential clients or recruiters want to read and see. So don't just add a photo, unless you're a photographer. Here, I'm using a quick Canva template, but of course, it's better to create it from scratch. Now let's talk about your LinkedIn network, which is the people you add. As you can see, when you don't have any first degree connections, you have access to very few or even 0 profiles. That's why it's important to start by adding your friends and family. You can ask them to send you a connection request or search for them specifically on LinkedIn. In any case, the more connections you have, the more LinkedIn profiles you will be able to see. And the more likely you will have someone in common with someone you're interested in, whether it's a potential client or a recruiter. What's more, you'll benefit from the natural sense of trust that comes from knowing someone in common. So go ahead and add your friends and family. LinkedIn understands this, which is why it also suggests people who work or study at the same place as you.
Don't forget to add a presentation about yourself. Since your experience and education are already on your profile, there's no need to mention
of them. The introduction is more of an opportunity to show your personality. Here I'm doing something quick, but keep in mind that you can use up to 2600 characters. So you can go ahead and write a longer text. And that's it. Of course, you can add interests to your feed and then use LinkedIn to find clients or just build your reputation. If you like the video, consider subscribing. It's always a pleasure. And of course, if you have any questions, I'm waiting for you in the comment section below. See you soon for more videos.